Welcome to a lesson on the root test for convergence of an infinite series. The root test states if we're given an infinite series generated by a sub n with the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n equals l, then if this limit is less than 1, the given series converges. If it's greater than 1, the given series diverges. And if the limit equals 1, then the test fails, and we have to apply a different test. And since the root test involves taking the nth root of a sub n, this is often a helpful test when our series is raised to the nth power. Before we take a look at our examples, it's important to remember that if we have the nth root of a, that is the same as a to the 1 over n power. Let's take a look at our first example. So right away we see this infinite series of a formula raised to the power of n. This is an indication that the nth root is going to help us determine if this series is convergent or divergent. So to apply the root test, we're going to take the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n. So we'll have the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of 4n squared plus 1 divided by 5n squared minus 8, all raised to the nth. Well, if we take the nth root of something raised to the nth power, this will just give us the radicand. So we'll have the limit as n approaches infinity of 4n squared plus 1 all over 5n squared minus 8. Well, for limits at infinity, if the degree of the numerator and denominator are the same, the limit will be the ratio of the leading coefficient. So this limit is equal to 4/5, which is less than 1, which is less than 1. And therefore, by the root test, the given series converges. Remember, by the root test, if this limit is less than 1, it converges. If it's greater than 1, it diverges. And if it equals 1, we have to apply a different test. Let's look at another example. Now notice for this infinite series, we don't have something raised to the nth power, but the exponents do contain n. So let's go ahead and see if we can apply the root test to this infinite series. Instead of writing this as the nth root, we're going to take a sub n and raise it to the 1 over n power, which is the exponent form of this radical. So we'll have n to the n minus 1 divided by 2 to the 3 plus n, all raised to the 1 over n power. Now remember, when you have powers raised to powers, you multiply the exponents. So this will be the same as the limit as n approaches infinity of n raised to the 1 over n times n minus 1 power. And this will be the same as 2 to the 1 over n times 3 plus n power. Now let's go ahead and simplify our exponents and see what that does for us. We'll have n raised to the power of, 1 over n times n, that'll give us 1. And then we'll have minus 1 over n. In our denominator, we'll have 2 to the 3 over n, and then we'll have plus 1. So notice as n approaches infinity, this approaches 0, and this also approaches 0. So as n approaches infinity, our numerator approaches infinity, and our denominator approaches 2 to the first. So our limit approaches positive infinity, which is greater than 1, and therefore, by the root test, the given series diverges. Let's go and look at one more example. Notice on this infinite series, both the numerator and denominator contain n as part of the exponent, which would lead us to try the root test. Again, instead of taking the nth root of a sub n, we'll go ahead and take a sub n and raise it to the 1 over n power. And now we'll multiply our exponents. Well, 3n times 1 over n would be 3, so we have e to the third. And then n times 1 over n would be just n to the first. Now as n approaches infinity, our numerator is fixed at e cubed. Our denominator increases without bound. So this limit is equal to 0, which is obviously less than 1. So by the root test, the given series converges. That'll do it for the root test. Thank you for watching.